Welcome to Jung Tuition. Let's continue discussing the basic issues in climate physics. Today, I will give you an informal talk on my research work published in 2021. The reason is that I have read some recent publication and noticed that some misconceptions I pointed out in my work still widely applied, still exist in literature. So let's have a look at what I have done a few years ago. I use decimals to illustrate my idea. In this window, the horizontal axis represents the absorptivity, long wave absorptivity of atmosphere. People would call it the absorption by greenhouse gases, including water vapor, CO2, and ozone, and so on. But personally, I would prefer just call it as infrared radiation absorbers, okay? Because in my opinion, the greenhouse is quite misleading because our atmosphere has nothing to do with a greenhouse in your backyard, as I mentioned before. The vertical represents the emissivity of the upward atmospheric emission, because that upward radiation or emission by the infrared radiation absorber is responsible for the cooling of our atmosphere, as well as the surface as a whole. Because that upward radiation will go to the much colder outer space. So remember, the vertical axis represents the emissivity of upward atmospheric emission. It could be by water vapor, could be by CO2. Okay. Until now, many people still take it for granted that we can apply Kirchhoff's law for radiation for studying of the atmosphere, okay? But this is fundamentally wrong, because Kirchhoff's law is valid for black body only, the ideal radiator and absorbers, okay? Often associated with condensed matter, solid in particular, not with a gaseous material such as our atmosphere. The basic assumption in my work is that to modify the Kirchhoff's law. Now, if I just use this, so this red curve represents the upward atmospheric emissivity as a function of the non-wave absorptivity. Absorptivity, you can treat it as a percentage of the radiation absorbed by the atmosphere from the surface. So remember, these red straight line only represent the dependence of the emissivity of black body on its absorptivity, which are equal according to Kirchhoff's laws. In my published work, I modified the Kirchhoff's law by adding a factors 1 over 1.1962. You see, as shown in this green color straight line. So this factor is actually determined by the assumption that at maximum absorptivity, which is a unit or one, the transmittance of atmosphere still equal to 10%, okay? Because there's an atmospheric window where no absorption occur, therefore, that window is always open, irrespective of how much water vapors or CO2 in our atmosphere. Although this change seems not very dramatic, well, as we expected, because after all, as first observed by John Tyndall, that the good absorber is also the good emitters. But my modification of Kirchhoff's law simply specifies that It is proportional, but not necessarily equal to, in the case of the gaseous material, such as water vapor and CO2. So basically, if, for example, if the absorptivity is 40%, 0.4, which means 40%, according to Kirchhoff's laws, that the emissivity is also 0.4 or 40%. But my modified Kirchhoff's equation suggests that the emissivity is slightly lower, 0.33 or 33%. So this is a basic assumption made in my research work published in 2021. Actually, I have made a video for this particular work. So if you are interested, you can watch that video as well. So what does this imply? So this green curve is the calculated transmittance or transmissivity of atmosphere as a function of the absorptivity of the atmosphere. Okay. It is actually a parabola, as you can see. Now, this time, the vertical axis will represent the transmittance, okay? The percentage of the of transmitted surface radiation at the top of atmosphere. The reason I draw this horizontal dashed line is just want to remind you the value for transmittance at 2 points are equal. These 2 points are zero, there's no absorption, or there's no greenhouse gases, and 0.4, the absorptivity is 0.4. In other words, 45% of the long wave surface radiation is absorbed by the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. I always use greenhouse gases, which means that the transmittance of atmosphere in the absence of the greenhouse gases is equal to the transmittance in the presence of the greenhouse gases, but the absorptivity is exactly 40%. Remember Manabi's talk, he mentioned that our as a whole, the atmosphere reduce the surface upward long wave radiation by 40%. So this is very intriguing functions of our planet called Earth. It can maintain its transmittance or transmission from surface to the outer space at 60%, very close to 60%. In the absence of the infrared radiation absorbers, or in the presence of infrared radiation absorbers. So that is a very important implication of my research. So in general, you can see as the absorptivity increase from the zero to unit, which is a maximum, which is 100%. That is a real scenario when all of the terrestrial long wave radiation is absorbed by the atmosphere. Even at this maximum absorptivity, the atmosphere still keeps its window open slightly to allow about 10% of the terrestrial radiation go out. So unlike the blanket effect, and the Earth has no way to send off its surface radiation through the atmosphere, which is not true, of course, according to my theoretical studies. The second important implication is perhaps a little bit shocking for many climate researchers. In other words, this curve theoretically predicted based on a modified Kirchhoff's law suggests that our planet as a whole can make its surface warm with or without infrared absorption absorber. That is quite different from the take-for-granted ideas in the climate researchers. How could it happen? Let's look at the upward emission. This blue color, straight line. So the upward emission increases as soon as the absorption by atmosphere occurs. That is why. Notice that the upward atmospherical emission increases linearly with the increase of the absorptivity. That is why the Earth as a whole can achieve its 60% transmittance in the presence of the long wave absorption by the greenhouse gases, again, by the infrared radiation absorbers, without modifying the original form of the Kirchhoff law for radiation. The dependence of the long wave transmittance on the long wave absorptivity is linear, okay, as shown by this dashed green line. However, according to my theoretical studies, the dependence of the transmittance of our atmosphere on the absorptivity is parabolic, is quadratic. I had tried to explain this idea to Dr. Hardy several times, but for some reason he found it difficult to accept. I don't know why, it's not complicated ideas. Okay, I hope this talk will help you to gain some new insight into how our planet can work